The CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents... I'm E.G. Marshall. If your game is suspense, mystery, we play it here. Join us. There are those who hold that marriages are made in heaven. There are also those who insist that marriages are consummated in hell. People marry for love, for convenience, for money, and now and then, they may even marry for murder.
Alaric, come in.
Thank you.
Well, good friend, what brings you here?
I owe you an explanation.
Why do you look so troubled?
I've been lying awake nights, wondering how to say it.
Well, why don't we have some wine? That'll loosen your tongue.
Oh, thank you, Carl, but I've come to a conclusion that there is no way to say it. There are no words to express it.
Well, then how...
It's something that has to be done. And then it speaks for itself. And so, I've come here to do it.
Alaric, have you gone mad?
This explains everything.
Our mystery drama, The Precious Killer, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by Sam Dan and stars Beatrice Strait and Arnold Moss. It is sponsored in part by Buick Motor Division and Sinoff, the sinus medicines. I'll be back shortly with Act One. There can be no peace, no truce, no ceasefire in the eternal war between good and evil. Who's ahead? It's hard to say. It appears that evil wins most of the battles, while good winds up winning most of the wars. Or is it the other way around? The problem is, we have angels and devils on both sides. The name of the country is Rurania. It is located in Middle Europe. It is an absolute dictatorship. The time is the present. Talking about time, anyone can be arrested at any time. The police just come around and kick in the door.
Shut up! Who are you?
Get out of bed.
Alaric! Alaric, it's me, Carol.
Get dressed.
Are you mad, Alaric? This is me, Carol.
Let's go.
Why? Why am I being arrested?
We don't have all night.
Why am I being arrested? I demand an answer.
Answer him, Benish.
You have no right. You have no right to...
He doesn't understand, Benish. Answer him again. That will do, Benish. I think he's getting the idea.
God! God!
I'm coming. Now, what's all this noise, Your Honor?
Do you know who I am?
I believe I do.
There's been a mistake. Why have I been arrested?
Because you committed a crime against the Republic.
No. I did no such thing.
Oh, but you did. Otherwise, you wouldn't be here.
But I am innocent. What crime did I commit?
I'm sure you know.
But I don't. You know who I am.
Oh, yes. Your Honor is Professor Carol Vortex.
That's right. I'm a hero of the Republic, a chief of scientific research. I demand to see the First Minister.
He would never come here.
Oh, yes, he will. I'm First Scientist of the Republic. I have the same rank. Have him sent for. At once.
Now, Your Honor, you just get some rest.
Wait. You're wearing the silver medal of the 1st of August. You're a veteran of the August Brigade.
Oh, yes.
My brigade.
How well I remember, Your Honor.
I recognize you. You're... No, don't tell me. You are... Rykov, 1st gunner in the 3rd company.
Yes, Your Honor. And you were a fine young officer. You were the best.
The August Brigade. We made the revolution.
That we did, Your Honor.
Rykov, why? Why am I here? Why?
Now, Your Honor, no point in fighting it. He'll tell you soon enough.
But when? I've been here 6 days. I've seen no one. I am losing my mind.
Oh, you mustn't do that, Your Honor.
My wife. But what about my wife? She must have come home from rehearsals and I was missing.
Oh, yes, your wife. I've seen her so many times. The greatest actress in the world.
When she came home, I was gone. Without a word, without a clue. What can she be thinking?
I'm sure by now she knows where you are.
I demand to see the First Minister.
You mustn't yell like that. You mustn't. There's nobody listening.
Where did you hide it, Carol?
Hide what? I don't know what you're talking about. What am I supposed to have done?
Where did you hide the platinum?
The platinum?
You supervise all the precious metals used for experiments. Where did you hide the platinum?
Well, it's in a laboratory, in a safe, where it belongs.
It's gone.
No.
Only you knew the combination.
But I didn't. I wouldn't. Well, what would I do with all that platinum?
You planned to leave the country.
Oh, no, that's a lie.
Is it? Were you not going to attend the International Metallurgical Convention in London?
Yes, but that's not leaving the country. I had permission to go. Everybody knew. Well, you knew. We talked about it.
And once in London, you would ask the British for asylum?
Oh, no. Never. This is my country.
And with platinum worth almost $1 million, you could start a brand new life for yourself.
Never.
Where did you hide the platinum?
I swear
How
to you, Alaric.
How did you propose to smuggle it out of the country?
Alaric, you're talking to me, to Carol. I am your best friend.
Where did you hide the platinum?
Will you get it through your head that I never had any...
Finish! And now we shall begin all over again. Where is the platinum?
I didn't steal anything.
It's a mistake. It's all a mistake.
Who is that? Who is that?
It's just me, Your Honor.
Rykov, machine gunner Rykov, 3rd Company, August Brigade, huh? Report, machine gunner Rykov.
Your Honor...
The ammunition, has it arrived?
Your Honor, wake up.
We'll attack just before midnight.
Listen to me.
Good, honest Rykov, the best gunner sergeant a lieutenant ever had.
Wake up, Your Honor.
Wake up. They can't tear a man loose from his home, his wife, his work, without warning, for no reason.
They want to see you.
They can't destroy... They want what?
They want to see you.
Who wants to see me?
The High Commissioner.
Why?
I don't know why.
Carol, look at me. Do you know who I am?
Yes.
Can you think clearly?
Here, drink this.
No. I don't want anything from you, Harry.
Oh, now, relax. It's all over.
What's over?
This ghastly mistake.
Mistake?
Yes, mistake. That's all it was.
And what now? Do we just shake hands, you and I, and that's to be the end of it?
Yes, Carol. That must be the end of it.
Oh, no, not for me.
Well, what is your complaint?
What is my complaint?
What law was violated? Well?
What law?
The law of the overwhelming right of the people.
Alaric, I don't want to argue. I only say there was no need to treat me like...
The law states the people must be protected from the insidious henchmen of imperialism and treason. The people must always use overwhelming force. The people must strike first and fast to obtain the confession from the guilty.
I don't care about...
First, last, and always, the law must protect the people, not the person. You wrote that sentence, Carol.
Please. I'm tired. I can't think.
Don't do that, Carol. Don't play the martyr with me. I suffered as much as you did. I could have sloughed off my responsibility. I could have given a subordinate the job. Instead, I did it myself.
May I ask why I was arrested and what was the mistake?
We received a tip that the platinum was missing. We had to suspect you, naturally. And then about an hour ago, your assistant, Trestoff, was picked up about 300 miles from here at the border.
Trestoff? Oh, that's impossible.
He was driving a van.
No, not Trestoff.
The platinum was in it. So you see...
Oh, yes. Yes, I do see. Well, and now...
Trestoff has been shot. Justice was done. And now you're free.
Free.
Free to go back to your wife, your work, your home.
As if nothing had happened.
Of course, my friend. It was all for the good of the people. Now we must shake hands and redouble our efforts to preserve our glorious revolution. Shall we?
Yes, Alaric. Certainly. Now... I am even more determined than ever to preserve our glorious revolution.
Well, you live your life happily, productively, convinced of the correctness of your beliefs. Suddenly, the firm ground beneath your feet turns to quicksand, and you are sucked into a horrible pit, which shows you your world from the underside. Can you believe again? Can you behave as if nothing happened? I'll return shortly with Act Two. Carol Vortic is one of the world's leading metallurgical scientists. He is also a hero of the People's Republic of Rurania. At this point, he is a somewhat bruised and battered hero because he has been in prison, and no one has ever confused the central prison of the People's Republic with a country club. However, it was all a mistake, and it has been sorted out and set to rights, and Carol has been returned to his job, his luxurious home, and his beautiful wife.
Katerina. Oh,
darling, I woke you. And I did try so hard to walk in quietly.
Oh, no. I've been up a while.
Well, that's not good. You should be sleeping. The doctor said you need rest, lots of rest.
How did it go at the theater?
Oh, I missed you. When I can't see you in your seat just before I make my entrance, I don't care.
I heard the review on the radio. It was a triumph.
It would have been a greater triumph if you'd been there.
The reviewer said, Katerina makes a stunning return to the theater, completely recovered from her illness. The divine Katerina proved, if proof were needed, why she is the first actress of the Republic.
Recovered from what illness? Oh, well, I can't expect them to say I refused to act and protest against your arrest.
You shouldn't have done it, Katerina. You should have fulfilled your responsibilities to the people.
Carol, I believe you're serious. You still prattle this nonsense, these incredible fairy tales about the people, and after what just happened? What beautiful flowers. Who sent them?
They arrived just after you left for the theater. They're from Alaric.
From whom?
Alaric. And on the card he writes, to the hero of the revolution.
Don't you ever mention the name of that monster in my presence. That evil beast, a fiend. He turns on you like some vicious serpent, and in return you bow, you scrape, you kiss his hand.
Katie, please.
The foul smell from these stupid flowers will not poison the air of my bedroom.
No, Katie, don't.
Oh, I'm sorry, Carol. I was just so lonely and miserable without you, so frightened. And that horrible Ulrich, posing as our best friend.
He is our best friend, darling.
Don't you say that after what he's done.
Well, what has he done? His duty as a citizen?
Oh, Carol, darling.
My oldest, my closest friend. We saved each other's lives. We were like brothers. And what hasn't he done for you, Kate?
I don't want to talk about Ulrich.
But we must. He can, with a blink of an eye, purge himself of all humanity, all emotion. Oh, Katerina, I see now. I know so little.
No! You're the most brilliant person in the whole country.
No, only when it comes to ideas. When I was very young, there was this idea of the people's sacred freedom. And I fought for that idea.
Darling, you're an immortal hero of the Republic.
And when I became an engineer, I was involved with things, but I never learned about people. Until just now. Human beings, suffering, pain, doubt, terror.
Oh, and now you must forget what happened.
No. No, because if I do, I will have learned nothing. Now, you were right all the time. You're an actress. You know people.
Carol, you look so tired.
This government, this life we lead here. Oh, I don't. It's all a nightmare.
Carol, please. You can be arrested for this.
You were right. You were right all along.
You'll feel better in the morning.
I'll never feel better until I breathe free air, live among free people.
Carol! Do you know what you're saying?
Yes. Darling, could you go?
Oh, I can't wait to leave this dreary dungeon, to act on a free stage.
It might not work.
I don't care.
We could be arrested.
I don't care.
Even shot.
I don't care. When?
In 3 weeks, we'll go to London for the scientific convention.
You can go, but can I get permission?
I have an idea. You can arrange a tour. Take all your wardrobe, your costumes.
Will they let me?
We need hard currency. People all over the world will pay to see you. You're one of Urania's greatest natural resources.
Yes, but I've never been permitted to make a tour before.
Well, there shouldn't be any problem. You know who can fix everything.
Oh, don't tell me.
Of course.
Oh, that's the cream of the jest. Ulrich. Oh, that will be sweet, sweet revenge. Little heart. You will never break again. What you do now will be remembered. You will die, but you will not be dead. You will live forever in the soul of the people.
No, I'm not up here. I want to go to my dressing room.
Thank you. Excuse me, please. Excuse me.
Hello, darling.
Ulrich.
You love me.
Do you have to ask?
Well, how did your husband, the first scientist of the Republic, respond?
It worked. You were right. You were so right. Poor Carol, he's really too much. A true patriot. You couldn't say a word against his precious People's Republic.
Well, some acquire wisdom through the brain. Some must learn through the body.
And you really worked him over.
Oh, no, not really.
Well, he's ready to defect.
That is only the first half, my dearest. After all, we will need the money to live comfortably in England.
Yes, but that's going to be a problem. He is very, very ethical. As you well know.
My darling, I'm not going to starve in the West because Carol is ethical.
Won't they like you in the West? You chose freedom, didn't you? Somebody will give you a good job.
Oh, they're bored with people like me. Besides, Rurania is too small a country. Half the world never even heard of us.
The money will be difficult.
Darling, the plan calls for him to become angry enough to defect, and then to steal the platinum in order to take it with him. And finally, for us...
Don't say kill him.
Render him inoperative?
I like that better.
Can you convince him to steal the platinum?
Listen, I can convince him to steal anything.
Let us drink to that.
Irina!
Yes, madam.
Is there champagne?
Yes, madam. The master sent you a bottle.
The master? Now, citizen Irina, we don't use the word master anymore. It's an insult to the free citizens.
Yes, Your Excellency.
I give up.
Please serve the champagne.
Yes, madam.
Irina, you will have all my costumes neatly hung away in the portable wardrobe chest. I'm going to London.
Yes, madam.
That will be all.
It seems to me we may have been a little bit too demonstrative in front of her.
Oh, she's a stupid woman. She doesn't think about anything except finding a boyfriend.
Oh, really? I would think she's too old for that.
A woman is never too old.
The problem is, I wish we could tell him somehow that all he has to do is put the damn platinum in the van and drive across the border. I would see to it that no guard stops him.
No. There's no way we can tell him that without making him suspect.
Very well, let him have fun conjuring up some brilliant plan in that scientific brain of his.
Yes, but how? How do we plan to get rid of him?
Oh, quickly, painlessly. After all, we're very old friends.
No. We're not going.
What?
I changed my mind.
Why?
Because it's the cowardly thing to do.
I don't understand.
This government is a crime against the human race, and I am part of that crime. I fought to create it, to support it. I am responsible.
You say you're responsible? Now, what does that mean? What will you do here now?
Refuse to work?
Will you be thrown in jail?
I'm not afraid.
But what good will that do?
Oh, I don't know. I wish I could fight them.
Well, you can.
No, no, Katie. They have the army, the police. Oh, I've been talking like a fool. But that's because I've been a fool all my life.
But you can fight, darling. You can fight them from London or New York or Paris or from anywhere in the free world.
Who would listen to me?
Everyone. You could publish a newspaper.
And that takes money.
But you have money.
I do.
Well, you could have money. The platinum. In your lab.
The platinum? The platinum belongs to the people.
Carol, you must not react without thinking. The platinum belongs to the oppressors of the people.
Wait. Oh, this is irony. I'd been accused falsely of stealing the platinum, and now...
Of course.
We must get it out of the country. How?
Well...
How?
Sometimes the simplest plan is the best. We could just try to drive it past the border in a car. Well, hide it in the sleeping bags and the camping gear, as if we were going on a trip.
No. That would never work. You can't get anything past our border guards.
Yes, it was just an idea.
Besides, we have to fly out of here. I'm going to a convention, and you're going on a tour. Now, let me apply some scientific thinking to this. How can I get that platinum out? Oh, no. No, I don't believe it.
You don't believe what?
What just flashed in my brain. It's so simple, so ridiculously easy. And it's absolutely foolproof.
What is?
This plan, this idea.
Oh, kill me.
No, darling. You're too important.
Well, if I'm so important, shouldn't I know?
No. Because if you knew, you might unconsciously give it away. Its success depends on your not knowing until exactly the right moment.
Now you know why he's first scientist of the People's Republic. Give him a problem that concerns things, and he can solve it while you wait. It would be better if he were that knowledgeable about people, especially his wife and his best friend. But I guess you can't have everything. However, you can have Act 3 in just a few moments. Problem. How do you smuggle a fortune in platinum past suspicious border guards? I imagine any of us would find this a formidable difficulty. However, Carol Vortick takes it all in stride. Carol Vortick is an eminent scientist. It's a pity he doesn't know more about people, especially about the people he loves.
Darling, you mean you won't tell me how we're going to get the platinum out?
Oh, I will, dear. Just as soon as we've done it.
Yes, but...
This is for your protection,
Katie. But I should know.
No. If you knew, it would make you nervous. And without intending to, you might betray yourself.
Oh, darling, I've never seen you so excited.
It's a challenge. You know me and challenges.
I'll leave you now.
Katie, darling, are we... Am I doing the right thing?
Of course we are.
Is it right for me to go into exile?
How can you even ask?
Just look at the poor, plain people, the ones who can't leave.
Angel, there's a basic unfairness to life, and one must live with it. The alternative is madness.
Yeah, but I love this country. How can I live in exile, never to hear this language, breathe this air?
You'll be working for freedom.
Yes. Well... I must get to work.
Hello?
Darling?
Yes, Katie?
I told you I could do anything with him. He's agreed.
I don't believe we need to be specific on the telephone. The answer, I assume, is positive?
Yes. As the Americans would say, we are go.
Your tour is also go.
Oh, marvelous.
How soon can you be ready to leave?
I only have to pack my clothes and my wardrobe, and you?
I'll have to burn a few bridges behind me before we meet again.
And,
Carol, he happens to be one of the bridges.
Oh.
I love you, Katie.
Oh. Oh, Professor, you frightened me.
I'm sorry, Irina.
What are you doing here, sir?
What am I doing here?
Oh, I'm sorry. I have no right to ask. After all, Madam is your wife, and I guess you have every right to be in her dressing room.
But it does seem odd to you that I'm here long after the theater has closed.
Oh, well, it is not my place to ask.
Well, I came here just to get some of Madame's things.
Oh, sir, you do not have to explain. You probably wonder why I'm here at this hour.
No, as a matter of fact, it didn't occur to me.
I sleep here, in the dressing room. Apartments are scarce and so expensive. I don't know what I'll do when Madame leaves. I won't have a job.
Oh, I'm sure she'll give you a handsome gift.
Well, she hasn't said anything about that.
Perhaps it just slipped her mind. Here, let me.
Oh, no, sir. I couldn't.
It's not really very much money.
Oh, it is, sir. For someone like me, it's a fortune.
Take it.
Oh, God bless you. Oh, I shouldn't have said that. I'm sorry. Don't be angry.
I'm not angry.
Oh, sir, you're a saint.
Huh?
Oh, I shouldn't have said that either.
Good night, Irina.
Well, what kept you?
Can't you hear, Alric, darling? They wouldn't let me leave the stage. 7 curtain calls.
You better go back and take another bow.
My final performance in Ruania.
How do you feel?
Wonderful. Oh, wonderful, darling. Everything's packed.
Everything?
I didn't know I had so many gowns, so many costumes. But it's all put together. And tomorrow morning, it all goes with me on the plane.
And the platinum?
He says I'm not to know till I arrive in London. And then he'll tell me. Do you think he's already managed to get it out of the country?
Well, I don't see how. He's been watched too closely.
I thought for a moment that he would try to hide it in my baggage, but that would be ridiculous. He knows it will be thoroughly searched.
No. I'm sure he has a plan. And I'm sure it will work.
Well, he says he'll tell me as soon as I arrive in London.
And then you must tell me, and I'll...
Yes, I know. Love me?
Kay, my darling, I've always loved you. That's why I made you first actress of the Republic. Come here.
Madam.
Oh, excuse me. How dare you come in without knocking?
I'm sorry.
Get out of here! Get your coat and hat and get out of here. And never come into this theater
but
again.
But, madam...
Get out!
Just a moment. What is your name?
Irina, your excellency.
Irina what?
Irina Rulin, sir.
Do you know who I am?
Oh, yes. Your excellency, yes.
If you should even whisper about what you saw here to any living soul, you will disappear. Do you understand, Irina?
Yes, your excellency.
Now you may leave.
Yes, Your Excellency.
I shouldn't have lost my temper. All she has to do is to tell Carol.
Is there a danger that she may?
Oh, I don't think so.
Because she could have an unfortunate accident in the next 15 minutes.
Oh, no. She'll never breathe a word. Actually, it's that stupidity of hers that gets me so irritated. Peasant. But why do we have to talk about her?
Indeed. Come here.
I won't see you for a few weeks. What am I going to do without you?
Like dirt they treat us.
Dear, do you have any money left, sweetheart?
I've got money.
Waiter, some wine, cheese. What would you like, sweetheart?
We're human, too. Now, I remember before the revolution you got treated like dirt. Is it any better now?
No, honey. What's your name again?
Irina Rulin. What's yours?
Everyone calls me Rykov.
Rykov? Rykov, I've got a problem.
Why shouldn't you have a problem? You're a member of the human race, aren't you?
He's a saint. And she's a devil.
Who? Who's a devil?
The great Katarina.
Oh, I love that woman.
She's a devil. But Master Carol, her husband, oh, he's a saint.
His Honor, Carol Vortic. Oh, they come no better. What an officer he was. Let me tell you about the time we were surrounded.
She is cheating on him.
She's what?
With his best friend.
Isn't that always the way?
Now, I don't know. Should I tell him? Now, you're a man. What do you think?
Now, that requires a bit of thought.
He's so good to me. And she treated me like dirt. What should I do, Rykov?
As an old soldier, let me tell you that you cannot make an important decision on an empty stomach. Waiter, some chicken, dumplings, boiled beef, potatoes.
Hello?
Darling?
Katie, darling. You arrived safely.
Yes, dearest. I'm in London. I'm breathing the free air of London.
Oh, how wonderful.
It's a bit smoggy, but it's free. Now, darling, can you talk to me?
About what?
You know about what?
Certainly, sure.
Where is it?
In London.
Oh, marvelous. Oh, darling, you did it.
No, darling. You did it.
Me? I don't understand.
Oh, precious, it's so simple.
Well, tell me.
See if you can figure it out.
Angel, I don't like riddles.
I'm taking a plane to London tomorrow. See if you can guess it by then.
Give me a hint.
Well, it arrived in London when you did.
And
that's all. Now, see if you can have the answer for me when I get there tomorrow. Darling, I have some loose ends to tie together. I love you. Goodbye.
Carol.
Hello?
Ulrich, my darling.
Dearest, you're in London.
Yes.
And the material?
It's here. It's here in London.
Ah, good. I'll leave tonight.
Ulrich, I...
Hello? Hello? Katie? Katie? Operator? Operator? Listen, I've been cut off. I was on the line to London.
Yes, sir.
Well, don't just say yes, sir. Do something.
I'm sorry, sir. We're having trouble with the London circuit.
This is a call of vital importance to the government.
Yes, sir, but we're still having trouble.
Oh. Doesn't matter. It's arrived. It's there. And now to burn the final bridge.
Alaric.
May I come in?
Why?
I have something to say to you. We'll never see each other again.
What makes you say that?
Well, you're going away. You won't return.
Are you sure?
I've come here to make sure.
What are you saying, Alaric?
I wondered... I stayed awake nights wondering how to say it. And the truth is, there's nothing to be said. No point to any conversation. You simply do what must be done.
Alaric!
This is what must be done. Quickly, efficiently, and finally.
Alaric, don't!
Not that it means anything. Not that it helps. But believe me, Carol. Believe me. I'm sorry.
Doing the right thing, Mykoff. Are you sure it's the right thing?
He should be told.
Well, maybe he doesn't want to know. Did you ever think of that? See? He isn't home. There's no one here. Let's go.
Wait. The door's open, you see?
Well, we can't just walk into...
I smell something.
What?
I'm an old soldier. I know that smell.
What is it?
Death.
Death? Oh! Saints preserve us. Are you a conjurer? How can you smell death?
You fool, I smell powder, gunpowder. Someone has fired a shot in here. Come on in.
I'm afraid. Oh! Look! On the floor!
Your Honor, Your Honor. Irina, call a doctor.
No. No, no. Is that you, Rykov?
A machine gunner, Rykov, reporting for duty, sir.
I'm... dying, Rykov.
Oh, no, sir, not you.
Listen to me. It's for the best. I would have died anyhow, away from our country, our language, our people.
Sir, try to save your strength.
I'm staying with you, with all those who believed in me, with all those who must stay and fight and suffer, who can't leave. I'm staying, Rykov. I'm staying.
Yes, sir.
Rykov, the good Lord must have sent you. Please get a message to my wife in London. Tell her that the coat hangers, the clothes hangers, the wire clothes hangers, that's how... Well, they're made They're made of... I made them out of... Well, that's how she carried it. That's...
Sir.
Your Honor.
Poor man. Delirious, crazy.
What was he saying about coat hangers?
Well, what's the difference? He was raving.
He wanted us to tell his wife something.
What?
I don't know. He said, get a message to my wife, and then he started raving about wire coat hangers.
Well, I'm sure that's not what he wanted us to tell her.
I guess not. She'd think we're crazy.
Well, I wouldn't tell that evil woman anything anyhow.
He was a good man. Let's pray for his soul.
I don't know. I don't know.
Katie, think.
Oh, maybe he was playing a joke.
What did he say exactly?
He said the platinum is here.
And? He said you should be able to figure it out. Well?
Don't you dare, you vicious animal.
Think. Where is it?
I don't know. I don't care. I wish I were dead.
We'll both be dead soon enough. We'll die of hunger.
Oh, why did I ever leave home? I can't get a job in this terrible country. I audition, they laugh at me. Why don't you work?
At what? Washing dishes?
What else are you good for?
Why don't you sell your costumes, your wardrobe?
Oh, they laugh at that.
Well, take them to a second-hand store, to the flea market. Anywhere. Maybe we can raise enough to buy dinner.
Oh, why do we ever leave Urania?
Because... Oh, what's the use? Get those clothes out of the wardrobe chests. No. Leave them hanging where they are. Maybe we can get a few extra pennies for the wire hangers, too.
Maybe. Well, if you're ever in London and in some old clothes shop or a flea market and you see some threadbare theatrical costumes, check out the hangers. The ordinary, everyday wire hangers. Who knows? Those humble hangers may be constructed of the purest platinum. Who knows? I know I shall return in a few moments. Precious metal. How men sell body and soul for it. Betray, kill, no holds barred. And yet, isn't it all a state of mind? Somewhere in the city of London, or who knows where by now, is a quantity of coat hangers made of platinum. To look, you would think, just ordinary wire. And why not? They do the job. A humble job, it's true, so why should anyone look twice? You should always look twice. Our cast included Beatrice Strait, Arnold Moss, Ralph Bell, Ann Petoniak, and Dan Ocko. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown.
And now, a preview of our next tale.
These documents show that Rasputin has sold millions of rubles worth of medical supplies to Germany, a country which is waging war against us. As payment, Rasputin has been given shares in the Süddeutsche munitions factory, as well as shares in Taunus Manufacturing and Copernicus Industries in Bavaria. Your Highness perhaps knows of these companies?
Little father, tell Colonel Amdur what you have told the Tsar and me.
Madame, it will make no difference to him.
Tell him.
It is a prophecy, Colonel, and it is this. If I die at the hands of the nobility or members of the court, the Tsar and the Tsarina will lose their crown and their son within 6 months of my death.
Radio Mystery Theater was sponsored in part by imported Vigna Rosé wine. This is E.G. Marshall inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.